get started, so let's get back to our ESN broadcast crew. You're listening to High School Sports on the Eli Sports Network.
Welcome back to the Eli Sports Network. Tony Dively here with Noel Vasquez as we get ready for SPS or GSHL 2A action between the Woodland Beavers and the RA Long Lumberjacks. As both teams huddled up on the sideline, Woodland, the home team in their white tops with the forest green numbers, black shorts, RA Long, and their visiting blacks with white numbers and white trim, red socks for the Jacks. As we are about ready to get underway here again, teams come in with similar records. RA Long comes in at 2-2, 4-4 overall on the season. Woodland comes in at 1-4 in league play, 4-5 overall on the season. Last game played by RA Long was the 31st of March, so they have been off for a while. Today is the 10th, so they've been off for at least 10 days. Same thing for Woodland. They lost to Mark Morris 1-0 in their last game on the 31st of March. So both teams coming off of a loss, I believe. Mark Morris beat Woodland 1-0. And as I wait for the page to load, and yeah, Ridgefield beat RA Long 1-0. So both of them coming off of 1-0 losses to league opponents. Teams make their way out onto the field. Starting keepers for both sides. It will be Filberto Alamia for Woodland, and for RA Long, it'll be Jose Radillo. The Jacks will start off with the ball first. Manny Cabrera will be the one to play it backwards now that everybody is pretty much going into that one man in the center circle now. Nobody playing two man up anymore. We'll see a mad dash coming from Woodland as they have numbers forward. And that ball will go to the back line, and puck. Emiliano will get it over to Hoppy. Hoppy to Jesus Cabrera. Jesus through traffic and gets it to Gerardo Hernandez. Gerardo over the top man was offsides. Ball will go to the back line. Forcier will put it up into the air. Knocked down by Manny Cabrera. Manny sidesteps one, still gets it over to Anderson. Brady turns, plays it over to Cabrera. Into the box it goes. Manny Cabrera, his cross will go right to the keeper. And Alamia. Alamia gets his first save of the game. Throws it out quickly up the field. It goes to Woodland. They were trying to lead Patrick Playtech. Taken back by the Beavers in the middle of the field. It'll come out wide to Mark Gonzalez. Gonzalez plays it in the middle of the field. That'll get past Thrall. Aiden trying to run it down. Coming out of the pack with it will be Trent Sneed. And that'll go back to Cruz Rivera Guzman. Cruz plays it a long way forward. That'll go all the way to Radillo, the keeper for RA Long, and Jose will scoop that one up. He'll throw it out wide to Quinn Anderson, and Quinn will get it towards brother Brady, but that'll be picked off by the midfield of Woodland. Taken back by Puck Emiliano, step over, another step over, a good job to get the forward to bite and allow him to get a pass to the middle of the field. Long pass over the top, onside is Manny Cabrera, but the ball goes off of his heel. Couldn't bring it down in front of himself. And now Woodland will move back up the field. Thrall with it. Thrall down the far sideline, trying to get around Anderson, and that will roll out off of Thrall. Long throw in goes to Jesus Cabrera. That'll roll back into the box for Radillo to scoop it up and looks to send it down the field.
You know, one of the things that I can tell you right now is I really like all day long. I like the way they play. They have great players, good touches, a lot of good ideas when they're making plays. The only thing that I wish Ari Long would fix is that direct ball to Manny Cabrera on the top. They go way too direct. They're too predictable with that, and they're letting the other defenses know pretty much what they're going to do for the rest of the day. You know, if they could play the ball back and be patient, and instead of just putting one long and take a couple touches, bait the defense and then make that long pass, that would work a lot better than just putting it over the heads of the defenders.
Either that, or you make that adjustment through the game as you start off early, lobbing them over the top, trying to spread that back line thin, and then as the game goes out, you start shorter passes until you can draw somebody on, and then you take that one final pass and get that open run on a goal. Here it'll be a throw-in for the Beavers on the far side of the field. Throwing in is going to be Trent Sneed. Sneed with a good throw-in towards Playtech. That'll go off of him and out of play. Throw a goal kick coming for the Jacks. Everybody back. Low line drive kick goes right to the foot of Playtech. He'll try to send it across, but that'll be cleared out nicely done by Benjamin Hoppe. Back it comes. Brady Anderson will cut off a pass, and then that'll go off the face of Mark Gomez trying to get that clearance. Woodland trying to save the ball in. They didn't look like they did from our angle, but no whistle. AR is on the opposite side of the field. Shot ping-pongs around, no good. That was Gomez that got the shot off. Here's a long shot that goes wide of everything from Trent Sneed, and it will be a goal kick coming for R.A. Long.
And Woodland already showing, you know, that this is their home turf. They're not going to back down, even though R.A. Long has scored 20-plus goals in the season already in the few games that they had. You know, Woodland knows what they're facing. They know that this is a pretty tough R.A. Long team, but they're not going to let him just walk in here and let him score. You know, right now they're dictating the pace of the game.
Yeah, they are doing a good job of moving the ball down the field nicely, working it back and forth. Here comes R.A. Long. Good chip over to Hernandez. Gerardo in the middle of the field. He'll lose the possession. Hernandez pointing at a ball, but everybody backpedaling instead of running at the ball for the Lumberjacks. Jacks, long pass over the top. Offside flag should have gone up, did not go up. Manny Cabrera gets around one. He was about three yards offside that time. No flag goes up. It'll be a goal kick to Woodland, and it looks like the keeper will take it.
Yeah, and even against Rochester, that they beat, the R.A. Long beat 7-1. One of the things that you notice, even with a leaky defense like Rochester's, they still get called offside. They play too direct, the ball up in the air, and I don't think Manny sometimes knows when teams are playing that outside trap or they're just, or he's just a couple steps in front. This should have been a call offside. Lucky for him, they didn't call it, but lucky for Woodland, the ball went out of bounds.
Mark Gomez plays it back to the back line. Working it up the field is Playtech. Playtech will go too far behind Gomez. It was a good give-and-go opportunity, but too far behind, and that comes back to the Jacks. That'll go off of Forsier and out of play. Throw-in for R.A. Long. Quinn Anderson goes to Puck Emiliano, puts it high into the air. Settling it was Levi Oram. He'll get it over to Thrall, Aiden Thrall. Up the far sideline, that'll go to Gomez. Gomez will go back to the back line. Go right back to Gomez, keeps it in place, sidesteps Puck, Emiliano. Can't run onto it, but it'll cut off that pass in front of Thrall. It'll go back to Forsier, to Gomez, Mark. Looking for a give and go with Playtech. Playtech instead will go opposite side, and that'll be cut off and sent up the field by Benjamin Hoppe. Over to the far side, DeMarcus Lies. Trying to get a ball forward, and that'll go off the head of one of Woodland's players that'll stay in play, though. long shot will go high and wide of everything. Taking that was Aiden Thrall. Long hair, don't care from Aiden Thrall.
Yeah, and it's one of those shots that you got to take early on the game. You know, you start pulling the defense towards you. They know that you can take those shots. So if you take one of those, we saw with Aberdeen's Miguel Torres. They gave him too much space, and, you know, he punished Black Hills last week, Friday night, with a couple shots from outside the 18 when we clearly said, you give this kid 5 yards, he's going to take a shot from outside, and he's going to end up putting one. But he ended up putting two in there.
There is handball not called on Woodland. Woodland will keep up the play. Physical play being allowed here early on. Gomez runs through a defender. That's cleared up by R.A. Long, taken back by the Jacks, though, in the middle of the field. Coming out of the pack is Jesus Cabrera. Jesus leads Manny. Manny onside. He'll go one-on-one with the keeper. Manny Cabrera, shot good. Manny Cabrera gets the opening goal 9 minutes into this. And Manny Cabrera, ball went straight through. Good play through from brother Jesus. The twins meet up and get a goal in.
Yeah, and that was a well played. It was a good ball by Jesus Cabrera with the right idea. The Woodland defender was able to put a foot under on it. It was just a bit too high, and the ball just leaked right underneath his cleat and went right to Manny's feet, and Manny just took it one-on-one. And we've seen this a couple times already. When Manny's one-on-one with a goalkeeper, he's not going to take a hard shot. He's not going to try to go chip the goalkeeper. He's going to make it nice and simple for him, nothing fancy, and just put in the bottom corner.
Yeah, he's not going to try to overpower the keeper. He's not one of those. He's a level-headed guy that him and his brother, twin brother, Jesus, they know how to play with each other, and they play well. And both of them are going to put a low-line drive in instead of trying to get a huge Sports Center-worthy shot. There's the first whistle of the match, and it'll be a free kick to Woodland. I didn't see what the play was that ended up being a whistle. There's been a lot more physical action going on rather than that. Free kick coming. Looks like taking it will be Brennan Lemieux. No, it won't be Lemieux. Step over and a low line drive went through everybody, missed the mark, was Kevin Terhorst. Pulls it wide. But it was a good attempt, because if that takes any kind of deflection off the wall, that's going back towards the goal, and nobody would have been prepared for it for the Jacks.
Yeah, definitely. It was one of those shots where you're expecting to hit someone's leg, and you just never know where it's going to end. Lucky for them, for Ari Long, he just went straight out. No one touched it. But there was also a forward for Woodland that could have put a foot in there if he would have slid and put his toe in there. But I don't think he saw that play coming.
Gomez to Thrall. This ball is blocked, and thought he cleared it up was Chesley. It ended up going right in front of him, but he lost where the play was. Woodland on the far side of the field trying to keep the play alive. That's Lemieux. Lemieux sidesteps one, goes to Thrall. Thrall lines up, takes a shot, pushes it wide, though. And Thrall is one of those that you're going to have to watch throughout the game. I don't think he's taken a shot within the box at all. So far, he will take them from distance anywhere on the field.
Yeah, and I think that our long defenders are starting to notice that he's able to take those shots from outside the 18. So if he can take shots from outside the 18, you can just imagine the things that he can do inside the box.
Yeah, he's done a good job of one touch, settle the ball down, turn, and it's not even that hard of a shot, but it comes off of his foot very well. And these don't look like dangerous shots end up being on target with more pace than you're thinking they are. Long clearance up the field. Manny Cabrera trying to run under the ball, cutting it off instead, doing a good job as Marcus Lees to stay in front of him. Lemieux back to Lees. That'll go out of bounds. Throw in coming. Throwing into the middle of the field was Zachary Chesley for the Jacks. Turning was Hernandez, Gerardo. That'll be cut off by the back line, and Lemereau will play it up the sideline too long. And that'll go all the way back to Ben Hoppe of R.A. Long on the back line. Sidestep, Jesus Cabrera. Sidestepped a couple, trying to lead it over the top to Manny Cabrera. Sidesteps one. Manny catches the keeper out of position, and that goes just wide of goal. It'll be a corner to R.A. Long.
And that was a good play by Manny to keep possession of the ball, even when he was being double-teamed and even pushed up a little bit. He's a tough guy. He's one of those guys that's not going to go down unless he gets a shot.
Keeper Alamillo was kind of out of position. Manny tried to take advantage of it. He sent a low shot in, but it just went wide. Here comes the corner. Puck will send it right back where it came from. Chip back post, and that'll go wide of goal. Trying to poke that in from the backside, I believe. That was Gerardo Hernandez coming back up to take the shot. Woodland will take it quickly. Jesus tries to go to Manny. Manny was going one way. Jesus went the other. I'll go back to the back line. And Orem, Levi, sends it forward. Hernandez will settle the ball. Gerardo. Cut off by Orem. And a restart for the Beavers. They'll lose the ball, though. Brady Anderson sidesteps one. Brady, the freshman, he'll get picked off by Thrall. Thrall will get it right back from Playtech to Gomez. Gomez back to Thrall in the middle of the field, over to Lemereau. Lemereau on the run. Lemereau looking for a cross in. He'll get cut off by Damian Perez, though, of R.A. Long. Back to Thrall. Thrall was looking for a one-touch give-and-go, but that ball got caught up on the inside of his foot. Instead, it'll be Jesus Cabrera chipping to the middle of the field to Puck to Manny Cabrera. Manny to the near side to Anderson. Anderson on the run. Anderson turns, spins, still trying to get around Forcier. Forcier shields off Anderson, and Anderson will go right into the back of Kevin Terhorst. That's who was guarding him, not Forcier. It was Terhorst. The captain's armband threw me off. Both of them wearing captain's armbands. Terhorst sends it down the field off the foot of Gomez, but Gomez will run back to it. Taking too hard of a first touch was Anderson. Forcier. Back to Playtech. Playtech sidesteps one, tries to split defenders. And Chesley will clear that one up for R.A. Long. Over it goes to Perez. Damian tries to sidestep one, spins on the ball on the far sideline. Step over, play to the middle of the field, but right to Thrall of Woodland. Thrall leads Gomez. Gomez has open room on the near side. Gomez took too long trying to go one-on-one. Gomez stops, turns, looking to play it back. Gomez goes into the box, back towards Playtech, and that'll be cleared out. Back to Jesus Cabrera. Jesus, long ball down the field. Onside is Manny Cabrera. Manny again will have one-on-one. Manny, low line drive shot, and Alamia. Alamia with a save that time. And again, it looked like he was offsides when that ball was played.
Yeah, it just looked like he was offsides, but he started his run right on the 50. And, you know, you're still on your own side of the field, so technically you're not offsides. He made a good run. I think he just felt the pressure coming from one of the Woodland defenders was that he was coming in pretty hard. I don't know, you know, at that point as a defender, are you looking to stop the shot any way you can by taking the player out or anything like that? Manny might have felt some of that tension coming to him, and he decided to take a shot. Not the best shot that we've seen from him, though.
Yeah, I tried to rush a shot, and he felt that pressure coming from behind by Levi Orem. Here's a play that comes into the box for R.A. Long. That gets cut off. Now the ball will be juggled around. Jesus Cabrera. Jesus through traffic gets cut off by Thrall. Thrall and Jesus going side by side. spinning on the ball. Keeping it alive is Mason Nickerson for R.A. Long. Switching sides, trying to go Brady Anderson's way. That gets cut off. Nicely done by the back line. Thrall to Lemereau. Lemereau to Gomez. Mark trying to set up Lemereau down the sideline. Lemereau will jump over the clearance from Quinn Anderson and ends up being a throw-in. Forcier will throw in. Ball goes off the knee of Gomez. Tried to play it out of the air. Instead, that'll be cleared out by R.A. Long. Perez will knock it away. Perez looking for a long run. Has Cabrera Manny trying to get around the defender. Manny sidesteps one, still with it. He'll play it backwards instead. Shot goes towards the goal, and that'll go wide of everything. Perez, Damian Perez took that long shot.
Yeah, and, you know, Damian Perez, a bit of an ambitious shot. You know, you're about 30, 35 yards out. There's no one around you from your own team. That's all Woodland defenders, all white jerseys. What do? He decides to take that shot. In my opinion, you should turn back, look for Jesus, and start a play from the middle of the field.
Subs coming in for Woodland, Devin Rice, Anthony Vega-Ponce, and Owen Terhorst check in for the Beavers. On the near side of the field, that is Kevin Terhorst, sent it down the field, cut off by Woodland, but not played well. Holding off of the ball was Hernandez, probably shouldn't have, though, probably should have kept on going to that. Woodland will work the ball up the field. Beavers. Good build to play. Thrall keeps it alive. Trying to sell a call. Didn't get there. Playtech to the middle of the field to Lemereau. Anderson goes to puck. Emiliano fakes the one pass. Gets around Devin Rice. Devin will lose it. Anderson trying to run onto it. Thrall will get there first. Thrall can't catch up. Long pass over the top, trying to run under it was Perez. This ball poked to the sideline. Gomez can't keep it in play. Throw in coming for R.A. Long. Quick throw in. Goes right back off the foot of Perez and out of play. Back over to Woodland. So we are halfway through this first half. 1-0. R.A. Long leads Woodland after a ninth-minute goal by Manny Cabrera.
Yeah, it's been a good game. It's not like, so, oh, there's a hard foul shot from behind, and he just looks like I can't see.
That looks Hernandez. Gerardo Hernandez. And it looks like he might have landed on the ball when he took a hard shoulder. He gets right back up, and he will take the free kick.
And I just don't think he was expecting the shoulder coming from the side. It was more from the back than from the side. And he's not the biggest guy out there on the field either.
He's not, but he has a huge foot. And that one goes into the box, almost gets by everybody. Cabrera trying to track that one from behind. The outward kick goes off of the head ref. And then Hernandez will take a deep, deep shot that was almost going to be on target. Floats over the top of the goal, but He showed that he can put it on from anywhere as well.
Yeah, one of the things that I wanted to say was, you know, we see Damian Perez playing on the outside forward position for R.A. Long. Last time we saw R.A. Long play Rochester, Gerardo Hernandez was playing in that position, and I thought they utilized him very well there. He was making some great runs and taking some pressure off Manny Cabrera when Jesus Cabrera was getting some balls through. He had multiple options. I feel like Jesus right now is just looking for his brother and not so much for Damian Perez.
And that's where they missed David Bueno. That spot that Jesus Cabrera is playing right now is where David Bueno starts. And Bueno is more of a distributor than Cabrera. Cabrera is used to running alongside of his brother, both of them trying to score goals. And Bueno is more of that possession, hold it, we'll play it when we can, we'll spread it around more evenly to everybody instead of searching for one man down the field. And that is where Hernandez would play normally, is where Perez plays. But since Bueno is out with an injury, they're going to have to adjust to that throughout the game. Puck gets bumped off the ball. Trying to run it down is Gomez, but coming up with the play instead is Benjamin Hoppe. Lemieux to the near side to Forcier. Forcier too far behind Rice, cut off by Quinn Anderson. Jesus to Manny Cabrera, back to Perez. Perez tries to switch sides over to Anderson. Brady couldn't run it down. Quinn will. Quinn takes too much time setting up, and he'll go to Brady Anderson. Brady sidesteps one, gets around Forcier. Brady sidestep again, cross, no good. But that'll go to Jesus Cabrera. Jesus plays it back to Hernandez. Gerardo too hard over the top of Perez, and that'll go out of play. Throw in coming for Woodland.
Yeah, and you can see some of the defenders for Woodland down here on the defensive side, they're struggling keeping up with the Cabrera brothers, just with Jesus trying to distribute the ball and Manny making runs. Some of the defenders already, you know, hands on their hips. They're thinking about different ways to take care of this problem, because I can tell that Jesus and Manny are starting to press a bit higher, and so is Anderson and Puck.
Yeah, they are all starting to press more and more as this game goes on, because as you said, they can see that their foot skills on ball are just so good that you can't guess one way or the other. You just have to backpedal and hope that they don't meg you in the process.
Yeah, and they're a young group of kids. They're a group of kids that looks like they enjoy playing together. They don't have to go forward all the time. They do most of the time when they're looking for Manny. But, you know, they also look for other options. It's not like they're just focused in that same person. Unfortunately for them, one of their better players in the midfield is out today. But that doesn't take the fact that they can play well with that person in or that person out.
This ball gets knocked out of bounds by Woodland. Throw in coming. Quinn Anderson will throw it in. No, it won't be Quinn Anderson throwing in. It will be Mason Nickerson throwing in. Nickerson, high throw in into the middle of the box, top of the box. Pushed over to Jesus Cabrera from Manny, but taken away by Thrall. Thrall on the run down the field. Thrall, long pass up. Goes too far behind his man. Couldn't run onto that. Was Anthony Vega Ponce. And Jesus Cabrera, long lead pass. Manny overran that ball. He was a little too quick on that one. That ball bounced behind him, and the defense able to make up ground and clear that one out. Lemieux to the far sideline to Gomez. Gomez gets it to the middle of the field to Snead, to Thrall, to Forcier. Forcier back to Thrall, up to Rice, cut off, though, by Quinn Anderson to Puck. Emiliano beats the triple team. Emiliano to the middle of this field. And Jesus will try to lob it over the top. Taking the worst of that was Trent Snead. Snead trying to shake things off. Nickerson with a sidestep. Nickerson still with the possession. Thrall will cut off his forward pass. Cabrera over the top. Jesus leads everybody too long. And Alamia.
You know, this RA Long team is trying to play, you know, up the field quite a bit. But at the same time, when they have possession of the ball, they're pretty smart with it. They don't rush the pass. They don't try to force anything either. You can see most of these kids doing step over the balls, you know, trying to juke their player out of their boots and get around them. And they're making those Woodland players chase quite a bit today.
Yeah, and everybody, the back line, midfield, everybody has a step-over move, it seems like, for R.A. Long, and that just is going to wear on you as the game goes on. Gomez goes down hard on the far sideline, and it's a good thing that Woodland has the more ready available subs to come in, because you see a lot of hands on hips already as we have about 12 and a half minutes to go in this first half, and Woodland already starting to suck wind a little bit. Cabrera Jesus to Anderson. Anderson redirect with the shoulder. Good redirect. Trying to go to Manny. Manny Cabrera. His pass too short. Cut off, though, by Hernandez. Gerardo trying to go through traffic to Perez. Can't get there. Puck will come out of the pack with it. Lemereau cuts that off from behind. And Lemereau making a long run. Emiliano Puck cuts him off. And Gerardo Hernandez will play it all the way back to the keeper. And keeper, Radio, gets a good clearance. That'll go to Manny Cabrera. Manny to Perez. Perez trying to get through traffic. Perez still on the run. Defender went down. Jesus Cabrera to Hernandez. Takes too hard of a first touch. And that'll go up the field. Lemereau, sidestep one. Lemereau fakes a long pass. Now he'll go to the far sideline to Gomez. Gomez, short pass over. That'll go to Playtech. Playtech to Orem. Back to Gomez. Back to Orem. To Sneed. Sneed stops, surveys. Goes to Forcier. Forcier will move it forward. Up to Thrall. Thrall bumped off by Puck. Emiliano gets there. And then Nickerson will sidestep. Nickerson on the run. Sidesteps another. Nickerson still moving up the field. Nickerson goes down. And Lemereau comes out of the pack with it. R.A. Longcoach not happy. There was no call there. Thought he got tripped from behind. But it'll be cleared up by R.A. Long over to Devin Rice. Rice, good lead pass, and there will be a free kick just outside of the box. And getting up to check in will be Julio Magana for R.A. Long, and Marcus Lies will check in for Woodland.
You know, it's interesting the way this game is being called as it is. You know, there's some plays that are very physical, players flying bodies all over the place, and the ref just let it go. And then you see a little shove from the side, and you know, the kid doesn't even fall, stays on its feet, like, continue playing, but the ref calls it back. So it's one of those where you're just going to have to adjust to what the ref wants to call instead of what the foul really is.
So Magana will check in for Brady Anderson, and Lies will check in for Devin Rice. Looks like Lemereau will take the free kick. Lemereau trying to go in, and Magana, who just checked in, will block the kick in the wall. Lemereau will steal the pass. Lemereau trying to go through one on everybody. Lemereau flicks it to himself. Puck trying to come up. Lemereau with the shot just over the goal. But wow, what a shot by Brennan Lemereau.
Definitely one of the better shots that Woodland has had in this first half. You know, there's only 10 minutes left here in the first half, and one of the few opportunities that Woodland has showed. This is probably one of the better, individual plays that one of the Woodland players has done. You know, they're struggling with getting the ball up the field. They're struggling with keeping possession and just taking the ball away from R.A. Long as it is. You know, they have the bigger bodies, but they just seem to be getting outplayed by the R.A. Long players right now.
Yeah, they're bigger, but R.A. Long is quicker and faster, and they're using that quickness to their advantage to try to take advantage of this Woodland team. Woodland coming up, shot by Gomez. Gomez blocked wide. That was a handball in the box. No call. Nickerson blocked that out. That is a huge save by Nickerson. Open goal from Gomez. Nickerson comes over and blocks it out. It'll be a corner to Woodland, but Nickerson with 8.5 minutes to go.
Yeah, and you can hear Brian Bogle, the head coach for Woodland, asking for a handball because it looked clearly to me like there was a handball in the play. It's one of those hard things to call from where we are, but if the referee doesn't call it, he doesn't call it. There's nothing we could do about it.
There's been, as we said throughout there, it looked like another handball on the other end that wasn't called, a couple of offsides that haven't been called. If you don't hear a whistle, play on. Ball into the middle of the field, taken by R.A. Long. Lumberjacks have it. Long pass over the top, trying to lead Manny Cabrera. Manny will take a long shot. That time, that was a good job by Manny Cabrera. He's been dribbling into the box the whole first half, And this one, that ball floated right to him, one touch bounce in front of him, tried to take that shot just outside of the box, goes over the crossbar, but that's a good job by him to keep the back line guessing to what he's going to do throughout the game.
Yeah, definitely. I think that's one of the better plays that he has done also as an individual player for RA Long. He decided to take that volley from right outside the 18 when the goalkeeper started coming forward. You know, you get the idea to the goalkeeper that you're one of those players that dribbles inside the 18, and all of a sudden you just take a shot from outside the box. You know, there's a lot of things that Manny can do. There's a lot of things that RA Long is doing right now that is just giving a hard time for Woodland to adapt.
Perez up the field. He'll go to the middle. Nobody in the area. Magana playing a forward role now for R.A. Long. Couldn't quite run that down. Here comes Gomez and Nickerson. Nickerson will tap it out of play. That'll go out for a throw-in for Woodland. As Gomez is really, I like him playing on this side. Once he moved to the opposite side of the field, he kind of got lost over there trying to go one-on-one with Hoppy. Hoppy has speed. I like him moving to the near side into the middle because that seems to be a more natural position for Gomez to be playing.
Yeah, he seems like he likes to cut inside the field and take that shot if he can. And he also, it's a pretty good player enough to pull some defenders with him.
Forcier tries to get a cross in, cut off, and that'll be cleared up by the RA Long Lumberjacks. Chesley will send it up. Ball goes out of bounds. Throw in coming for the Jacks. Just under 6 minutes to go in the first half. 1-0, RA Long leads Woodland in GSHL 2A action. RA Long throw in goes off of Jesus Cabrera to the middle of the field. Switching sides to Forcier. Forcier gets one through Magana, but won't get by Quinn Anderson. And then sending it up was Trent Sneed. That'll go too hard off the side of his foot, and he'll end up having a throw-in. Sub will check in. Checking in is Cruz Rivera Guzman. He'll replace Anthony Vega Ponce. And it smells like fireworks going off here at Woodland High School. Ball over to Rivera Guzman. Back to Forcier. Forcier trying to get around Quinn Anderson. Quinn will knock it off of Forcier. Goal kick coming. And that was a good play by Quinn Anderson to knock it off of him. Forcier in full stride trying to get a cross in. And Anderson just got a foot in there enough to flick it back off of him. Too long for him to stop it. And out of play. Goal kick coming.
Chris Rivera Guzman, the player that just subbed in for Woodland, a small guy, pretty speedy. One of the things that I already noticed with him is that, you know, it looks like their coaches told him, hey, when that defense is playing with the ball back there, I need you to press him as hard as you can. Because as soon as Anderson got the ball in the back, he was being pressured by Cruz quite a bit.
And Rivera Guzman, he could be one that he helps out a lot because he can match speed for speed. He's that small, quick guy instead of the big body that can go in there. He matches up well with what R.A. Long does. Sneed looking to throw in. Sneed tries to go long, and that'll be sent out by Magana. Header comes right back in from Orem and Quinn Anderson. Towards the sideline, Magana keeps it alive. Magana shields off one, and that ball will go out off of Rivera Guzman. With just about 3 minutes to go in the first half, Emiliano Puck will throw in to Quinn Anderson. Quinn settles the ball. Lemereau up the field. Lemereau around one, but through. Couldn't find Cruz Rivera Guzman. And that'll go out for a goal kick and for R.A. Long.
That was the right play for Cruz Rivera Guzman to cut across right behind the defender just in time to get the ball. Unfortunately for him, the ball was placed right behind him, so he wasn't able to maintain control. But they're getting the right idea when they're attacking forward now, you know. They're actually matching up the speed with the defenders, and and the possession also. They're picking up possession. They're maintaining the ball on their own on the already long side of the field, at least for the last 10 minutes.
Yeah, they're doing a good job of a lot better job of maintaining a possession and stringing together a play. Here comes a good one. Lemereau through to Gomez. Gomez gets shielded off. Great play. Huge play by Zachary Chesley with 2:11 to go. Zach Chesley comes up with a big poke away from Gomez. It'll end up being a corner for Woodland. But Chesley, what a play by him to knock it away. Lemereau will take the corner. Lemereau in the air. That'll go right off the keeper. Ball still battling around. And into the back of the net with the goal is Gomez. Keeper got a hand on it, bounced through his hands and behind him, and Gomez gets the equalizer in stoppage time. 38-plus, and Mark Gomez with the goal just sent it into the top of the net. That ball batted around, and R.A. Long couldn't clear very well. Radio looked to make the catch. Ball slips through his hands. And by the time he got back into the front of the goal, that ball was already in. Nothing he could do about it.
Yeah, it's one of those plays where you just give the goalkeeper for R.A. Long gave Woodland a second chance by letting the fumbling the ball off his hands. It's not a complicated save to make, but he made it a lot harder than it should have been.
Jesus Cabrera tried to get an answer immediately. Him and Manny trying to go back and forth. And Jesus sends it over the crossbar. It'll be a goal kick instead to the Beavers. Goal kick coming. Terhorst will take it. Kevin flicked backwards to Lemereau. Lemereau over the top. And missing it was Chesley onside. Shot, and that'll go right to Radio. Trying to get another one was Mark Gomez. That was just a miss by Chesley. Tried to play the ball out of the air. And that will be halftime. At the half, 1-1 Woodland and R.A. Long in a good GSHL 2A matchup. We will be back with the halftime show here on the Eli Sports Network.
Fitscape Health Club is a different kind of fitness experience. Fitscape is for those who are serious about their workouts and want to get in and out without long waits for equipment and simply want to work out and get back to your routine. Fitscape Health Club on South Glen Centralia has great equipment from free weights to top-line cardio equipment to professional personal training. Fitscape should be your choice to reach your fitness goals. Stop in today at 1610 South Glen Centralia or call 807-8273.
Good Health Nutrition Center in Centralia is your home base for nutrition. When you visit Good Health Nutrition Center, you'll find the largest selection of vitamins, supplements, and natural remedies. You may be surprised to also find a huge selection of healthy groceries such as gluten-free products, environmentally friendly products, organic fruits and vegetables, and items for specific diets like the diabetic diet. Good Health Nutrition Center, powering students and athletes from the inside out. Good Health Nutrition Center on Harrison in Centralia.
The Holiday Inn Express in Chehalis is pleased to support the student athletes that dedicate themselves to be the best they can be. The Holiday Inn Express offers large, clean rooms with an indoor pool, fitness center, spa, free breakfast, Wi-Fi, and business center. The Chehalis Holiday Inn Express also has two meeting rooms and can accommodate up to 100. Call for more details or go online at hiexpress.com, or you can click on the Holiday Inn Express advertisement on the Eli Sports Network. When you are looking to stay overnight, remember the Holiday Inn Express.
OB Credit Union is your local credit union. At OB Credit Union, you can open a personal or checking account and plan for your financial future. Dave Littleton is a financial advisor and waiting to hear from you today. Dave can help plan for your future and put in safeguards for when times get tough, your future will be protected. OB Credit Union is a longtime community member and supporter of local students. Stop in today at OB Credit Union in Lacey, Tumwater, and Tenino. The Pacific Athletic Center is excited about the expansion of our Express basketball teams, featuring 5th through 8th grade and high school girls teams and boys teams 5th, 7th, and 8th grades. Players for the Express receive exposure to the highest level of competition. Our dedicated practice facility, individual training and coaching from our experienced staff, plus top-line gear and for parents, affordable pricing and available scholarships. Check out the PAC Express at PacificExpressBasketball.com or find our link under Youth Sports on the ESN homepage.
One half is now in the books, and we're ready for a recap with the halftime show. The best in high school sports coverage is right here on the Eli Sports Network.
And welcome back to Woodland High School. Tony Davila here with Noah Vasquez and Paul Beatty at halftime. It is 1-1 Woodland and R.A. Long in GSHL 2A action. The Eli Sports Network here is... we are filming for YouTube as well, so if you're watching that, it's been a very good first half so far, back and forth. A little one-sided at the beginning. R.A. Long did a good job of moving up and down the field early on. Woodland did a good job of making some in-game adjustments as the game went on, and they started to stop the long runs taken by R.A. Long and started answering back with their own counters that they were doing. A really good play, heads up play by Mark Gomez to get a goal, because everybody, the ball was taken on a corner, keeper came out, and Jose Radio went to punch the ball out, or went to catch it, whatever he tried to do. It's like he couldn't make up his mind if he was going to catch it or punch it out, and the ball just slips right through the middle of his hands. And by the time he could make up ground and backpedal the ball, it was batted around enough that Gomez was able to get under it and put it in the back of the net for the equalizer goal in stoppage time in the first half.
Yeah, you know, Jose Rodillo, the goalkeeper for R.A. Long, like you said, it didn't look like he knew what he wanted to do. It was not a complicated shot. It wasn't anything out of this world. I think he's made greater saves with harder shots and more complicated than what just happened. You know, it's one of those things that you just got to let go for the second half, and it's a new game again. Woodland started this game controlling the midfield and actually moving the ball up the field to a breakaway play by Manny Cabrera, assisted by his brother Jesus, and then he was able to place the ball in the bottom left corner for the 1-0. But till that point, it was Woodland for the first 9 minutes till Manny scored that goal. After that, it was all of R.A. Long just pushing on the other side of the 50, making plays happen, being, you know, that aggressive R.A. Long that we always see with Hernandez playing and Puck being the physical guys and Anderson making plays on the back and why not. But eventually kind of just died out. Woodland started taking this open space that R.A. Long left open for them, and they took advantage of the second chance that they got from the mistake from Jose Radillo.
Yeah, there were a lot of opportunities late for Woodland, starting at about the 8:30 mark to go in the first half. There was another misstep by Radio. He came out to the top of the box, and I believe it was Gomez again that flicked the ball over the top of him, and he was backpedaling, but it was a save. You can't see the air quotes that I'm making. But Mason Nickerson, it looked like he made a save in the middle of the box. Might have possibly been with his hand, but there was no call. HR was trailing the play, no call on it, so play on. But he does make the save and knock the ball out for a corner. But that stopped that run. And then again, Zachary Chesley, keeper, came out, couldn't make a play on it. With about 2:11 to go in the first half, Chesley able to clear that led to that corner that led to the goal. So it was a really good job by Woodland to keep the pressure up, but bad job by R.A. Long clearing late in the game.
Yeah, definitely. It's one of those things that, you know, it's all, I believe, of a mental game. You know, it's one of those things where you got to psych yourself out to be like, okay, we got to move over from this goal. We just gave up a mistake, and they took advantage of it. But, you know, as soon as Woodland scored that goal, Mark Gomez scored that goal on that mistake by Rodillo in the back, 2 seconds later, Jesus Cabrera takes a long shot, and then they get a huge goal kick, and then a bad clearance by the R.A. Long defense. Mark Gomez goes one-on-one with the goalkeeper. Unfortunately for Mark, he didn't hit the ball as hard as he wanted. He just kind of rolled to the hands of Rodillo. But that shows you that Woodland's picking up their game. That shows you that, you know, they're not going to go anywhere. Even if you score another one, you know, Woodland is not a team that is just going to stay behind and just let you lead and score another one. You know, if it's a one-point game, they're going to stay there with you to the final whistle.
Yeah, they're gonna make adjustments like we saw in the first half. We saw them sub in and out, and every player was talked to one at right before they went in or they came out of the game to see what they're seeing on the field so that they can make adjustments on the fly and match up better with these quicker, faster R.A. Long players. R.A. Long has done a good job moving up and down the field. They've shown that they can sidestep and they can do stepovers, and they've got fancy footwork. Woodland, they were biting on those stepovers early, and now later as the game went on, they stopped taking those bites and they just started backpedaling with them and didn't eat on the fakes that are going at them, and that made a huge difference because they were able to get those stick moves in and counter the ball down the field and make a good run of play that R.A. Long was doing early on.
Yeah, we'll just have to see here in the second half here in a couple minutes what R.A. Long is going to do, because the momentum right now, it's on Woodland's side. They're at home. They actually have a pretty decent crowd. You know, they're trying to be a win one for their families that came out here to support them. R.A. Long, you know, they know they have the skill to do it. But my question for them is, are you going to adjust to what Woodland's doing to you now? Because they have the momentum, and you're just starting to slow down, cool down. We talked for a minute or two of how Woodland was looking tired, and all of a sudden they just came back and possessed the ball till they got a goal in there.
Yeah, nothing gives you a second win like getting a tying goal late in a first half. All right, that will do it for the halftime show. When we come back, it will be second half action between Woodland and R.A. Long after this.
Now that you're caught up on the stats and opinions with the halftime show, we're now just moments away from live action on the Eli Sports Network.
Port Centralia supports all students in their endeavor to reach greatness from the classroom to the field. The Port Centralia knows our students are the key to our future, just like the port can be the key to yours. The Port Centralia is located halfway between Portland and Seattle, with easy I-5 access both north and south and rail links. You'll find low taxes in Lewis County, affordable housing, good schools, and an innovative community college, all important aspects for your growing business. The Port Centralia has the space you need for manufacturing, warehouse, office space, and developable land. Retail owners, listen up. Our new Centralia Station 40-acre retail and office complex is coming soon. We have high-profile space for you right off I-5. For more information on Port Centralia opportunities, call us today at 360-736-3527 or go online to the Port Centralia website at portofcentralia.com. Your business future awaits at the Port of Centralia.
And welcome back to the Eli Sports Network. Here from Woodland High School, Tony Davila with Noel Vasquez and Paul Beatty. 1-1. We are tied coming into the second half. It will be Woodland starting off with the opening possession of the second half. Woodland, the home team, in their white jerseys, forest green numbers, and black shorts. R.A. Long comes in with their all blacks, red socks, with white numbers and white trim. Keepers stay the same. Filberto Alamia for Woodland and Jose Radio for R.A. Long. And if for R.A. Long, one thing I want to see them possibly do is move Gerardo Hernandez up to more of an attacking position. If they're going to bring Magana in, that he can play that stopper defensive role and let Gerardo move up the field and switch places with either Damian Perez or with Brady Anderson, Emiliano Puck. One of them could move back into a more defensive midfield role and allow Hernandez to move up a little bit more.
Yeah, and that's one of the things that Ari Long needs to do, because right now they're just getting started and Woodland just seems to feel very comfortable moving the ball around, finding those open space, and they're actually starting to make runs here early in the second half already. I mean, it's only been a couple minutes and you can already see Ari Long under pressure. And if you're Ari Long, how much are you missing David Bueno?
Yeah, it has been a big difference so far. Cross comes in, and that'll be headed down by R.A. Long. Trying to run it down will be Sneed. And Woodland already coming out trying to attack early and often in the second half. They wanted to get that second goal quickly. It won't happen as soon as they wanted it to, but that was still a good run of play. They moved up one of the backline players in Marquise Lees. They moved him down one of the flanks, and he is playing a more forward position than he did in the whole first half, as they're playing three men back right now for Woodland.
Yeah, this is a Woodland team that it's going to come here in the second half, and they're just going to try to control the pace of the game from the beginning till the end. If they can get another goal, it's even better for them. But they know, and they have in the back of their minds that, you know, they have Jesus Cabrera, they have Manny Cabrera, and Gerardo Hernandez. They're three players that are going to make a play of a counterattack. If they take advantage of that counterattack, you know they're very dangerous, especially if they get in front of the goal and do a one-on-one.
Yeah, the one thing to note that I'm seeing right now is they have Owen Terhorst one-on-one with Manny Cabrera on the near side, wide open, lots of room to run. If Cabrera can get by him in any way, shape, or form, that is going to be a dangerous run of play for R.A. Long. And here's a free kick coming for R.A. Long, little push off in the backside of the field. Hernandez will set up to take the free kick. Gerardo will send it up to Hoppy. Hoppy dispossessed, but not for long. Hernandez lobs one over to Manny Cabrera. Manny sidesteps one. Cabrera on the run. Works on Terhorst and goes too far ahead of himself. Sneed up to Gomez. Mark, the goal scorer in the first half, will play it back to the back line across the field to Forcier. Jesus Cabrera to Manny. Manny chips it over to Perez. Perez stops, turns, plays it back to Jesus, and Jesus goes down. There will be a free kick just outside of the box, as there will be a – it will be a free kick. It won't be a PK. It was outside of the box. And they'll say that Forcier got leg, and it looked like – Cabrera just kicked ground and went down. He ended up hurting himself, but it didn't look like that was that forceful of a play for him to go down that hard.
Yeah, definitely. You know, it's one of those things that you just kind of go with the play, but this is probably one of the best plays that I've seen Damian Perez been involved in. You know, this is one of the better passing.
Hernandez tried to send it in. That'll go wide of goal, making the diving attempt was Filiberto Alamia. Alamia was going to be on the spot that he needed to be, but that ball was just pushed wide by Hernandez, but it was a good shot just wide of post.
Yeah, and Filiberto Alamia, he's actually a pretty decent size goalkeeper. That's, you know, in my experience, that's the size of a goalkeeper that you want. Tall, thick guy, good build, and someone that can actually stretch and dive from wherever they're standing. He's one of those guys that you can trust in the back. He's made actually a couple saves in this game against the Cabrera brothers that is just helping Woodland stay in the game.
There's a foul in the middle of the field on Woodland. Woodland will try to take it quickly from a spot that was a little bit off, trying to go too fast, and they'll have to reset and start over on that free kick. Coming up to take it is going to be Kevin Terhorst. Kevin will back up, trying to chip it over the top. Header sent up by Chesley. to Manny Cabrera, and Manny will lob one up. It'll go off a four-seamer. It'll be played back to the back line. Perez trying to make his man miss. And then it'll go all the way back to Owen Terhorst. Owen will lose it to Cabrera, but he'll get it right back. Cabrera took too hard of a first touch. Cut off, and that ball will be sent to the middle of the field to Lemereau. Lemereau to the sideline to Forcier. Up the far sideline. Stop turn was Rivera Guzman. Back to Jesus Cabrera. Jesus stops, turns, and his pocket is picked by Lemereau. Lemereau, near sideline, goes behind Lees. Lees has to stop and make up ground. Back to Lemereau, chipped over to Lees. Lees gets it back to Gomez. Mark Gomez, dispossessed by Hernandez. And there is a yellow to Gomez. So first yellow issued to either side, and a yellow given to Mark Gomez, the goal scorer in the first half for Woodland. It didn't look like that physical of a play. It looked like there was a little bit of a jersey pull, but he might have said something on the field that got him that yellow.
Yeah, definitely. I think this is the first or second foul he gets called on, and he already got, you know, a yellow card. And you know, he's one of those players that you don't want to get in foul trouble, like you would say in basketball, because you're going to need him. You're going to need that guy that smells the goal and, you know, that has a better chance of scoring for your team.
Yeah, he's a guy that he's one of those classic finishers that a lot of teams miss because he's willing to take a shot from anywhere. Here's a long pass up to him, looking for the cross. He'll stop, turn, and then he'll be taken down. It'll be a corner coming for Woodland. Beavers will have their third corner of the match. Coming over to take it is going to be Aiden Thrall.
And they're making better decisions on the plays that they're pushing forward with. I think Woodland is actually thinking on how to develop a better play instead of just trying to go to Mark Gomez every time. They're actually finding different amount of players on the field that they can rely on, not just one.
Brennan Lemereau takes the corner instead, and that'll go off the crossbar. That was almost a super pretty goal coming from Lemereau off the corner. Just a chip shot that almost falls in.
Yeah, and, you know, we already saw the goalkeeper for RA Long, Rodillo, struggle with high balls. It's one of those things that if you're a goalkeeper, that has to be one of your strongest things to do. Unfortunately for him, he's having a really hard time today getting some balls up in the air.
Yeah, it hasn't been the best play so far that we've seen from Medillo, especially throughout his career. He's been a pretty sure-handed keeper for the most part that I've seen him, and you can see that he's kind of struggling in this game. Everybody has an off day, and his has seemed to come today. Long pass up towards Perez. Perez will run it down, trying to get around his man. Sidesteps one. Perez, long shot will just go wide. Couldn't bring it down. Damian Perez did beat his man, but couldn't take the right angle to get the shot to go in.
Yeah, and I think he knows it himself. He's putting his jersey in his mouth, biting it, you know, with so much anger because he knows that's one of the few chances he's gotten today, and he didn't take advantage. He was pretty much one-on-one. Hard angle to take a shot, but it's one of those things that you kind of just adjust as you go. You know, you either blast it on the near post up high or try to put it down low across the body of the goalkeeper like he tried to. Unfortunately for him, it went out of bounds. One of the things that I do like about RA Long that they did here in the second half is that they noticed that Damian Perez wasn't doing much on the wing side, so they switch him up with Manny Cabrera because now Manny can actually get control of the ball and dribble from the outside into the middle and take an open shot if he can.
Free kick coming for RA Long, taken by Hernandez. And that ball will go out of bounds off of R.A. Long, off of Perez. Sub will check in. Jeremy Forget Tardif will check in. Forget Tardif will replace Marquise Lees. Lemereau taken away by Jesus Cabrera to Manny Cabrera. Manny to the middle of the field. Goes to Emiliano Puck. Puck back heel to himself. Puck will get dispossessed. Gomez will lose the possession. Nickerson comes out of the pack with it. Back goes Gomez. Gomez trying to get around his man on the run. Gomez with a shot will go wide of goal. Tried to tip it around the defender. Running next to him was Chesley. And Chesley did a good job of moving out of the way before that ball deflected off of him.
Yeah, and Brandon Lambrew, it's just pretty much the Jesus Carrera for Woodland. They're doing exactly with what Ari Long was doing in the first half with Jesus and Manny Cabrera. Now it's Woodland doing the same thing, utilizing Gomez on the top, posting him up with the last defender for Ari Long, and try pretty much the same strategy as Ari Long, see who does better here in the second half.
Gomez trying to get a ball back. That ball's too long, taken back by Woodland. Coming out of the pack with it is Forget Tardif. Forget Tardif sidesteps one but can't get by the next. Lemoreaux will take a crossing shot. Cleared up, though, by R.A. Long. Puck to Manny Cabrera, and Manny over the top towards Perez. Perez trying to take an angle. Keeper will come out. And Alamia will get the save. Field. It goes to Sneed. Sneed, long lead pass to Thrall. Thrall on the run. Thrall trying to get to that corner to get across, and Aiden Thrall with the cross goes to Gomez. Gomez in the box looking to turn and take a shot. Shot is blocked. Chesley with that block shot. Leads to a counter. Here comes Brady Anderson. That ball will be pushed out of bounds by Forcier, but Brady working that far sideline. Trying to get around one, but Chesley again, his second big save of the game on the back line for R.A. Long.
Yeah, and if you're coach Max Anderson for R.A. Long, you're thinking, why is Mark Gomez getting the ball so much here early in the second half? He's just touching the ball as much as he can, and he's able to turn and take shots. Lucky for Max Anderson, the coach for R.A. Long, he has his defenders set in place and blocking those shots, because as right now, you just don't know if he gets another open shot. Is he going to put in the back of the net or not?
Lemoreaux with the steal. Lemoreaux goes to the far sideline as Woodland starts to try to flank R.A. Long more and more. One on three, Lemoreaux. Lemoreaux gets through the three, and then that'll be played out nicely done by Mason Nickerson to get that one out of danger. Cruz Rivera Guzman came out of the game on that last dead ball. Anthony Vega Ponce checked in. Throw in on the far side of the field. Lots of bodies in the box for both teams. Numbers forward, high throw in. Lemoreaux will flick it backwards, trying to turn. Two players run into each other for Woodland. Gomez ran into his man. Gomez still with the ball, trying to play it over, and Chesley will clear it up. Chesley didn't get a great clearance. That'll go to Orem. Orem trying to go back to Thrall, but that'll be taken by R.A. Long. Manny Cabrera through traffic. Manny gets his man onside. Perez, Perez, one on two. Perez into the box. Perez will get taken down. Hard slide, but play on. It was a good slide. That was all ball taken that time. Hernandez, Gerardo with it. Stops, turns, works the far sideline. Hernandez still with it. Turns, works on Thrall. Thrall will hook him, and there's a free kick. Coach Vogel not happy with it, but that was right in front of him and the official. There was too much body in there. Yep. By Thrall.
But Gerardo Hernandez is one of those players that once he has the ball on his feet, if that ball is on his feet, it's like he has it glued to his boot, because it's very hard to get that ball off him.
Hernandez, long kick. Cabrera tries to keep it alive, turns, and that'll go wide of goal. Goal kick coming, falling away, trying to get that cross in. No good, and it'll be a goal kick coming for Woodland. Kevin Terhorst will take it. Terhorst up the field. Knocked down by Woodland, but taken by Brady Anderson. Brady's upward pass is knocked away and then sent out of bounds by Woodland. A throw-in coming. And throwing in on the far side of the field would be Quinn Anderson. As we are, there are just under 25 minutes to go in the second half, tied at ones between Woodland and R.A. Long. Pass up the field. Lemoreaux trying to lead Gomez. Couldn't quite get it to him. And across the field as these lobs start to come in both sides. Hernandez over the top trying to lead Perez. Perez gets held up enough by Orem. And then Jesus Cabrera will block a pass over to Manny. Manny up top. Manny through traffic. Manny will go down. Leaving his feet, trying to get a whistle, didn't get it. And now R.A. Long playing a man down. As everybody's slowing to watch and make sure that Manny gets up. Jesus Cabrera up the field. Jesus through traffic. Keeps it alive. Jesus tips it to himself, looking for the cross. Has an option. Sidesteps one. Jesus still with it. Stops, turns, still at the top of the box. Cross sent out by the back line of Woodland and then knocked out of bounds off of Puck. Throw in coming for the Beavers. That was a good run of play by Jesus Cabrera. Working that near sideline, able to get the cross in, but nobody there on the end of it. Puck will block the throw in. It'll go to Jesus Cabrera. Jesus will go to the far side towards Brady Anderson, and then Brady and Anthony Vega Ponce. Vega Ponce was watching the ball and didn't see that Anderson was right in front of him, and he ran through the back of him.
And this is going to be one of those things where if you're R.A. Long, you need to start paying more attention of the decision-making that you're doing, because a lot of those passes are going forward with no purpose. You're losing a lot of possession, and it seems like Woodland is taking advantage of that. They're starting to build something, and once they start building something, we saw it on the first half, they can make something happen.
It's more of a scramble. Everything's a scramble for R.A. Long, and it's more precision passing from Woodland throughout this second half so far to start things off. Perez can't control the ball off the chest. It'll come back up to Gomez. Gomez will control it off the chest. Gomez maybe a little too hard and off of his own chest, and that ball will roll out towards Radio. He will let it go, and it'll be a goal kick to the Jacks. Couple of subs get up to check in for Woodland. Marcus Lees and Damian Rice will get up to check in, see if they will not be able to get in since it is R.A. Long's goal kick. Hernandez will send it up the field. Hernandez takes his time. He thought they were going to make the sub. Instead, he'll play it out to Quinn Anderson. Quinn up the far sideline to Brady, to Puck. Emiliano gets around one, does not keep it alive down the sideline. Too close to the sideline it went.
And it's
it'll be a free kick to R.A. Long. They'll say that he got tripped up, and that's why he couldn't catch up to the ball.
But, I mean, it's one of those things that, you know, you still have possession of the ball. I mean, they might have played advantage. They didn't see the advantage, so they called it back. But at the same time, it's one of those things. I said it earlier here in the first half. I just don't understand the way that the game is being called. There's been some very physical plays that, you know, they kind of just let him go. And there's been little trips like this where maybe they stepped on your shoelace and everything is it's bad. It's a foul. You know, you almost want to give him a yellow card for that. And it's hard for the coaches to adapt of what's going on the field.
And Emiliano Puck was slow to get up. The official had to come over and check on him, and now he'll be subbed out. Julio Magana will check back in for R.A. Long as Puck takes the long way around the field to try to check back in. Hernandez, long kick off the head. Not a great decision that time by Kevin Terhorst. The keeper, Alamia, has to make himself known that he's got that ball.
Yeah,
he was going to catch that clean out of the air. Instead, it leads to a corner.
And there's nobody from R.A. Long in that area inside your own six. That's one of those things where you just gave R.A. Long a corner kick and a chance to score.
and taking that corner, it's going to be Hernandez. Gerardo will set it up. He's had good placement on his kicks. See if he can't get any here. Cabrera Jesus got a head on it, but didn't get enough of the flick on to put that in the back of the net. It just rolls out across the face of goal. But that was a good placement on that ball. Jesus tried to put as much on it as he could, and instead it just grazes him and goes out wide. Goal kick coming for the Beavers. Ball sent to the middle of the field. Taken by Lemereau. Lemereau turns. That'll go off the shoulder of Hoppy. Over to Brady Anderson. Brady will win it back. Sends it high into the air towards Jesus Cabrera. Orem will get there. And Orem up to Lemereau. Lemereau to the far sideline. Over to Devin Rice. Rice back to Lemereau. Lemereau through traffic. Ball cut off. Bad play over and can't get the convergence on it. Marcus Lees had a wide open shot. I didn't think he thought the ball was going to get to him. That was just a horrible clearance by R.A. Long, and they can breathe a sigh of relief because Lees had an open goal. Keeper was out of position, and instead it looked like he tried to pass it instead of taking the shot on goal.
Yeah, he tried to pass it to Mark Gomez that was making the run on the back post, but you're inside the box. You're pretty much in front of the goal, the PK spot. That's one of those things where you got to be a bit more selfish. That's one of those things where if you're that Woodland player, you just need to put it in the back of the net without thinking about it.
Here is Lemereau. Over it goes to Thrall, and Thrall will take a deep shot. That'll go wide of goal. But, yeah, that was one that you could see right away that Lees, as soon as that ball went off of his foot, he picked up his jersey and bit it because he knew he missed an opportunity to get the winning goal, or at least the leading goal at this point in the game, and just missed that opportunity, that big, big opportunity for the Beavers.
Yeah, it's one of those close games where either team has a chance to score. Right now, Willen, of course, is possessing most of the game, but it's still one of those games where anyone can score. We've seen it before. And, you know, when it's those type of games, if you're down on the field, if you're a coach for either team, you know the time goes by a lot faster. And you just want those players to put the ball in.
Manny Cabrera tried to get a call. Both the Cabreras now hitting the ground a lot more, trying to get these calls. There haven't been a lot of calls like that throughout the game. I don't know why they're trying to sell them now. There have been a couple of hard tackles, but it's been the softer touches that have been getting the calls, and now both of them trying to make up calls as they're going and trying to win them by throwing themselves onto the ground, and it's not working.
Yeah, right now I believe it was Manny Cabrera, the first one that went down a couple seconds ago, and you know he's over here robbing his touching his knee like he got kicked or his ankle, why not, and you know. He sees that his brother kept possession of the ball. He just jumped back up like the pain just magically disappeared.
Yeah, it was like a Euro game all over. Watching too much Premiership and not enough of the games that are really going to work for him. Ball down the field. Magana over to Jesus Cabrera. Jesus didn't feel the pressure coming from behind from Lees. Lees will have it up the field. Turns. Marcus, touch over, trying to go to Gomez, but too far in front of him. And this is one, like you said, they're going to Gomez one too many times, and everybody's starting to cover him. Jesus Cabrera through traffic. Jesus can't get by the second man coming out of it. Instead is Stahl. It's Thrall. Thrall with it. He'll lose it up the field. It'll go back to Terhorst, Kevin Terhorst. To the far sideline, Devin Rice. His pass is cut off, but Devin will get it right back. Play over to Lemereau. Lemereau stops, takes a shot from distance. It's a good field goal, but that doesn't help you in soccer.
Yeah, it's a far shot, and we've seen a couple players for Woodland actually attempting to take shots from a distance. I mean, think about it. If I'm Coach Brian Bogle, I just go out there at halftime and I tell my kids, hey, you see what just happened to the goalkeeper for R.A. Long? He spit when he fumbled one off his hands, an easy catch. you just never know. Take those opportunities, take those shots from outside the 18, and you just never know what you're going to get out of them.
Gerardo Hernandez, and there's another deep shot from Lemereau. Hernandez mishandled the goal kick. It was a straight line drive on the ground, and they're lucky that they come away with that one. Another deep shot taken, but now it looks like Woodland's going to start firing from deep. Jeremy Forget Tardif is going to check in. Checking out will be Marquise Lees.
And then right now, Marquise Lees is going out, talk to probably to Coach Brian, and he's going to have to explain himself what happened on that play where he should have put one on the back of the net.
Ball forward, Manny Cabrera trying to run it down. Manny takes a knee on one, trying to run it down. Can he get there? He'll get there, stop it and play. Manny does get it over to Perez. Perez, his cross in the top of the box to Jesus Cabrera. Jesus with a shot and a goal! Jesus. No, it wasn't a goal. Was it? It was a goal. Jesus Cabrera did get the goal. Jesus Cabrera flicks it over the keeper, and he does get the goal. Jesus Cabrera, what a nice goal by him with just under 14 minutes to go in the match. And Jesus with the goal. Great shot by him.
Yeah, I think, you know, some of the people on the bleachers and even the coach for Woodland are thinking, how is that a goal? The ball roll probably went through a hole on the side of the net because it even fooled us. But, yeah, it was a nice play. Everything started with that long ball that Manny Cabrera was able to stop at the out-of-bounds line and pass it back to Perez, and Perez put it in top of the 18 to Jesus Cabrera. Jesus Cabrera took the defender one-on-one. Goalkeeper came out and just chipped it over him as the goalkeeper's momentum was coming forward.
Yeah, it took a crazy angle and got that goal in. And right now it is R.A. Long leading Woodland 2-1. The Cabreras getting goals, both of them. Jesus and Manny Cabrera both with goals. Throw in deep in the corner for Woodland. Not a great throw in as they were looking to set something up that didn't seem to come out of anything. Orem will play it back to the back line. A couple of subs looking to check in for Woodland as well. Ball to the middle of the field to Lemereau. Lemereau goes around one, but Chesley clears things up. Back to Thrall. Thrall keeps it on the ground on the far sideline. Sidestep by one, taking the pass is Forcier. And offside flag goes up. Subs will check in. Cruz Rivera Guzman and Ivan Volsky will check in for Woodland. This will be the first time we've seen Volsky in this game.
You know, going back to the goal for R.A. Long, you start thinking about what happened on the goal that Manny Cabrera scored in the first half. Woodland had possession of the ball. Woodland was dominating the game, and then Manny scores. Same thing is starting to happen here in the second half, where Woodland's controlling most of the match here in the second half, and just a breakaway play by Manny and Jesus, including Perez on there, makes something happen. And then all of a sudden, you know, you're up 2-1 when your team wasn't even dominating the pitch. Now,
and like here's a corner, a great play that time by Perez. Perez did not quit on the play. As Orem was slowing down, again, we saw this in the last game with Aberdeen and Black Hills, trying to block the player instead of making sure that the ball goes out for a throw-in and not a corner. But good job by Perez to track the play and send the ball off of the defender. Corner comes in, up for grabs, trying to get there is Anderson, Brady Anderson. Bumped off the ball. Flag goes up on the far side. It might be a free kick for R.A. Long. See what the play is going to, what the call is going to be. Going to run down the ball is Quinn Anderson. And it'll be a throw-in, it looks like, to the Jacks. And Quinn will throw it in to Jesus Cabrera. Jesus lobs it over his head. Orem will knock it out of the air. Knocked down by Manny. Manny trying to one-touch it as he was sliding forward. That ball is dispossessed. Ball will go to Hernandez. Gerardo trying to get around Lemereau. Lemereau, long lead pass. Great lead pass to Gomez. Mark Gomez shot and a save by Radio. Great catch. As that ball was floating away from him, Radio had to backpedal, makes the big save for the Jacks to maintain this 2-1 lead.
Yeah, this is where you as a goalkeeper for Ari Long, you kind of redeem yourself for
Magana
that.
Magana gets around Orem, but Magana will get called. It looks like that was feet tangling, and that was another one of those that questionable call. Magana was full stride watching the ball bounce and just runs through the back of the player. They've been called both ways, though, so it's a good call. Chesley will play it out of bounds.
And I said it at the beginning of the game when Ari Long scored, don't count Woodland out because they're that team that likes to come back. Right now they're showing it. They're putting a lot of people inside the 18 now, and they're going to try to make something happen here in the last 10 minutes.
Orem throws in to Thrall. Thrall flicks it to himself, looking for the cross. Thrall knocked it down, and Chesley will clear. Chesley clears up the field right in front of his coach. Good clearance that time by Chesley. Orem with the throw in to Thrall. Thrall heads it to himself around Hernandez. And then chipping it through the legs was Jesus Cabrera. Back to Orem, back to Thrall. Thrall will go down, free kick coming for the Beavers. Beavers were wanting to take it quickly. Thrall will take the kick. And head coach Anderson for R.A. Long telling his guys to get back. Don't watch, just everybody get back. And Thrall is wanting that 10 yards. He's saying Magana is too close to him. Thrall, opposite side, ball headed down, knocked away, but missing it was Sneed. Long ball, has an opportunity, is Hernandez. Hernandez, Magana doing a good job making sure he's onside. Hernandez tried to tip it through. Hernandez too far ahead of himself, and that's a good save by Alamia. That was a little too selfish on the part of Hernandez. He had his man Magana. If he would have played that ball, Magana could have made a better run onto the ball and stayed onside. Shot comes in. Radio can't get the save, but he'll get the rebound. Offside flag was up anyway on Woodland, but Radio made a better save that time. Couldn't catch the ball clean, but takes it off the top of the foot of the far side player for Woodland.
Yeah, going back to that last play with Gerardo Hernandez when he tried to take the two defenders 2-on-1, and his partner on the top didn't make a run for the ball either. You know, in those opportunities like that, if you're the forward and you don't have possession of the ball, you have to make a run wide so you can draw one of those defenders with you and give a better chance to Gerardo to beat that player 1-on-1.
Long shot sent wide of goal by Lemereau. But yeah, that was one that Magana, he was running down the middle of the field. He sucked in his defender, but Gerardo Hernandez ran right at him. He didn't go wide one way or the other. If you're going to go that way, you send the ball wide and hope Magana will go that way and be able to run the ball down to help out and give another outlet pass or an option to be able to take a shot. Mark Gomez trying to play it through, and Chesley will play it out. Chesley has been huge on that back line for R.A. Long. Zachary Chesley made a big save early on, and now he's cleared out a couple of balls in. That would be very dangerous for the Beavers. With just under 6 minutes to go in regulation, Woodland has a throw-in deep in Jack's territory. Thrall heads it to himself, ball up for grabs, trying to flick it backwards, and Will, good flick back by Hoppy, and that'll go out of bounds, but it's a little bit better positioning now for R.A. Long to be able to run onto it. Trent Sneed with a throw in, headed right back out by Hoppy. And all right long, more than happy to keep on lobbing this out of bounds and let it run down the track. Ball will go back to Orem. Orem sets up the crossing pass, trying to play it out of the air, was Playtech. In other words, Owen Terhorst. Woodland keeps it alive to Rivera Guzman. Rivera Guzman will lose it. Magana, long pass over the top, trying to lead Brady Anderson, but getting there first will be Kevin Terhorst. And Kevin will throw in quickly. He'll outpace the young freshman trying to run down the far sideline.
Also, Kevin is about 6 feet tall.
Yeah, longer stride, able to run a little bit better. Uses a little bit more ground as he's got a longer stride. Anderson again trying to run it down, and Terhorst will get there again. This time Anderson will block the forward kick. It'll bounce to the middle of the field, but nobody there for R.A. Long. Lemereau out of the pack with it to Lees. Lees juggles it to himself. R.A. Long saying a handball, but no call. Orem too far in front of Gomez, out of play, throw in coming for the Jacks. And the Jacks will take their time jogging to that ball, looking to eat as much clock as they can as the game goes on. With just under 4 minutes, about 3:40 to go in regulation, R.A. Long leading Woodland 2-1. Chesley knocks the ball down and then sends it high into the air to midfield, opposite side. Long pass over the top, knocked down by Woodland. Woodland, Lemereau. Lemereau to the middle of the field towards Rivera Guzman. Sidestep by Hernandez up to Perez. Perez tries to get around Thrall, but Thrall will get there first. Makes the better play on the ball. Lees flicks it over his head towards Thrall. Thrall can't keep it in play. Throw in for R.A. Long. Throwing in will be Hoppy. Down the sideline to Perez. Perez flicks it to himself, keeps it alive. Perez cuts back middle of the field. Perez takes a long, low shot. That'll be scooped up. Keeper almost lost it. That was a dangerous almost drop there as Brady Anderson was right behind him that whole time. Rivera Guzman up to Lemereau. Lemereau trying to blow by the defender, and coming up with a big play was Magana. Julio makes a big stop, and there's a long clearance up the field. Orem will send it up to Owen Terhorst. To Lemereau, flicks it up into the air, looking for that turn and shot. Instead, it'll end up at the foot of Jesus Cabrera. Jesus turns, sends it up to the middle of the field. Nobody there. Orem will settle it down to Thrall. Thrall gets it to Rivera Guzman. 2 minute stoppage time period now. Looking for a cross. Cross comes in. It'll go off the leg of the defender. Corner coming for Woodland.
And we're on stoppage time. So this is one of those things that, you know, you just kind of put everybody inside the box and hope for the best. If you're Coach Brian Bogle, you're just hoping that something goes in here, and let's see if we can get a tie. Even the goalkeeper for, you know, Woodland, Filiberto Almadilla, is on the 50. Just in case the ball goes out there, you just put it back inside the box.
And this is where they scored last time. Ball went off the keeper's hands, went into the air, and they were able to get that goal, that bouncing goal in. Ball batted around, cleared out. Not great. Cross can come back in. Cross comes in and missing it. Ball still up for grabs and pushed wide of goal by Orem. Just missed.
And they call it a goal kick when it clearly looked to me like it deflected off one of R.A. Long's defenders. That ball to me looked like it was going to goal. It hit somebody on the back and it went to the out-of-bounds line. But they called it a goal kick. So, I mean, that's why we see a couple players for Woodland pretty upset for the call, but there's nothing much you can do once it's called.
No, there's nothing you can do there. You can just back up and play on, but there's not a whole lot of time left to play on. Hernandez takes the goal kick to the middle of the field, cut off by Thrall. Thrall up the field. Thrall tripped up just enough. Lots of contact. Magana will come back and keep the ball on the ground. Pushed over to Terhorst. Terhorst, his shot goes off of not a great place for Manny Cabrera. Manny Cabrera, wow, he not the best place to take a point-blank shot from. He went down pretty hard, but he'll pop back up, walk it off. Hernandez takes the kick up the field, free kick. Knocked down by Terhorst, Kevin Terhorst. Lamoureux to Gomez, Mark. Plays it to the near sideline to Lees. Lees chips it up into the air. Rodillo will come out. Miscommunication on the back line, but nobody is there. And that is full time. End of the match. R.A. Long gets the win over the Woodland Beavers 2-1. And R.A. Long will move up in the rankings. No, they won't. They will stay right where they are as they will move up to 3-2 in league play. Woodland will fall to 1-5, 4-6 overall. R.A. Long goes to 3-2, 5-4 overall. And the coach, Vogel, gets a yellow after the final whistle. Coach not happy with that call at the end of the game on that corner. And Coach Vogel comes out with a yellow at the end of the game. Must have said something that the official did not like. That's the we've seen two games now where there has been a yellow after the official whistle has been blown. And it's going to end up being one of those that you'll see it later throughout the season if that ends up coming into play more and more. Because if you accumulate so many yellows, that's the same as a red, and you'll be missing a game if that ends up happening a few more times. All right, once I get my mouse working again, that will do it for this part. We will be back with the postgame show here on the Eli Sports Network.
The clock has expired and the game is over. And next is the postgame show on the Eli Sports Network.
Weichert Reynolds Realty in Olympia is proud to support all student athletes as they strive to be the best. There are a lot of similarities between athletes and the professionals you'll meet at Weichert Reynolds Realty. Both know that hard work is not enough to be the best, but you must couple that hard work with attention to detail. Focus on the big picture. Be creative and inventive, and those are just the obvious traits. When you come through the doors of Weichert Reynolds Realty at 2532 Pacific Avenue in Olympia, you will be taken care of by their team of all-stars. Looking to buy or sell in Thurston County and surrounding areas? Your first call should be to Weichert Reynolds Real Estate at 360-412-6731. When it comes to real estate, turn to the pros at Weichert Reynolds.
The United Way of Lewis County is pleased to support the youth of our country in their endeavors in competitive sports and all extracurricular activities. We also support families through our many United Way agencies. Right now, it's an extremely important time for the United Way of Lewis County. It is our fundraising drive to help support the 16 agencies that serve the public. It's easy to help with a donation. Simply go online to lewiscountyuw.com and make a direct donation or create a workplace direct donation campaign. The United Way of Lewis County, serving your needs today.
Port of Centralia supports all students in their endeavor to reach greatness from the classroom to the field. The Port of Centralia knows our students are the key to our future, just like the port can be the key to yours. The Port of Centralia is located halfway between Portland and Seattle, with easy I-5 access both north and south and rail links. You'll find low taxes in Lewis County, affordable housing, good schools, and an innovative community college, all important aspects for your growing business. The Port of Centralia has the space you need for manufacturing, warehouse, office space, and developable land. Retail owners, listen up. Our new Centralia Station 40-acre retail and office complex is coming soon. We have high-profile space for you right off I-5. For more information on Port of Centralia opportunities, call us today at 360-736-3527 or go online to the Port of Centralia website at portofcentralia.com. Your business future awaits at the Port of Centralia.
The final score is on the board, and now it's time to recap the numbers on the post-game show here on the ESN Network.
And welcome back to the Eli Sports Network. Tony Davila here with Noel Vasquez, Paul Beatty, as 2-1 R.A. Long comes away a winner here at Woodland High School. Woodland falls to 1-5 in league play. R.A. Long moves up to 3-2. Goals coming for R.A. Long. One in the first half in the ninth minute, coming off the foot of Manny Cabrera with the assist to Jesus Cabrera. And then Woodland got the equalizer goal in stoppage time off of a goal from Mark Gomez. Gomez gets the equalizer in stoppage time. In the second half, they were all knotted up until the 66th minute when Jesus Cabrera followed a pass that was sent forward by Damian Perez along the baseline, and Cabrera took probably the most improbable shot you could take, chips it over the keeper straight down the line, and that ball rolls into the back of the net. It went through a hole in the side of the net, so we weren't sure at first when the ball went in, but it was a goal and a winning goal at that for Jesus Cabrera. All right, it is time now for our Tommy Lowe of Green Realty Players of the Game. Remember, Tommy Lowe is a helper in realty. Your partner in real estate success all throughout the state, really. You can go anywhere in the state. So check out Tommy Lowe of the Green Realty Group. And our players of the game for the Woodland Beavers went with Mark Gomez. He was the guy that they were looking for throughout the first half. He got the tying goal at the moment for Woodland, but he had a huge impact throughout the game for the Woodland Beavers. And for the I'm going to switch it up on us. For the R.A. Long Lumberjacks, I'm going to go with Jesus Cabrera as the player of the game. Jesus assisted on the first goal. He scored the second goal. He did a really good job moving up and down the field. He was that go-to presence. He replaced David Bueno in the middle of the field, playing out of his natural position and more of a distributing midfielder than his natural forward position. So Jesus Cabrera will be our player of the game. So players of the game for Woodland, it will be Mark Gomez. For R.A. Long, it will be Jesus Cabrera. And time now for our proactive PT play of the game. Remember, proactive is a game changer in your everyday life. If you need help, if you're injured and need some help, they can help you with that. Or if you need to increase your 40 time, your vertical, anything like that, they can help you with that as well. Training, they have a locations in Tumwater, Olympia, and Lacey. Check out proactive physical therapy in the Thurston County area. And for our play of the game, several to choose from throughout the game. The first goal set up, that was a nice play over the top to Manny Cabrera. Manny gets the first goal of the game. Second goal was beautiful for Woodland, but we don't like to double dip. So Jesus Cabrera, he assisted on one. He got the goal on the other. I am going to go with a different player for play of the game, and that will go to one Mr. Zachary Chesley with 2:11 to go, him blocking a pass out of the middle of the box in the first half. Yes, Woodland did score right after that, but that would have been back-to-back goals by Woodland late in the first half that would have put them up 2-1 instead of that 1-1 tie. And that was and Zachary Chesley had a big push for my player of the game. He played excellent in the second half on that back line. Chesley played very, very well, so we will give it to him on that play of the game. The ball into the middle of the box, he made a good play, cleared it out, made a lot of goal-saving clearances for Zachary throughout the game. So we will give him that play of the game for clearing that shot out of the middle of the box while the keeper was out of position.
Yeah, definitely. I think he deserves that, the player of the game for that, or the play of the game for that, because, you know, like you said, he had a good game in the back. He was one of those players that was picking up the slack for his teammates on the back line that were struggling clearing the ball. And on that play, especially, he had to run and help his other teammate and, you know, beat Gomez on that last touch when he was about to put it in for a go-ahead goal right before the end of the first half. I think it was one of the better plays towards the game. And, you know, it was a really good game between these two teams. Woodland, you know, it's a home team, and they're pretty broken down right now. I can see some players out there that are a bit upset with how officiating went, but it is what it is. There's still a lot more games to go, and you just never know, you know. You show that you can compete today, but, you know, it just depends how you're going to come out for the next day.
Yeah, it definitely does, and you can see that there's some little things as the coach got a yellow after the final whistle was blown. Coach Brian Vogel gets a yellow. Not happy with that last run of play. Thought they earned another corner. Wasn't given that corner. It looked like it was clearly off of one of the RA Long players, but official didn't see it that way. And Coach Vogel made his opinion heard and got a yellow for it. So there's where your opinion matters there. All right, that will do it for us here from Woodland High School. Tony Davila, Noah Vasquez, Paul Beatty, as Woodland falls to RA Long 2-1 in GSHL 2A action. Thank you for listening. Check out the site. We've got baseball planned. If it's nice, then we will have baseball. If it's not, then that will be canceled. We'll have more soccer throughout the week as well. And also there is a lot of other things going out, so keep on checking out our site and see what we have coming up and what is going on with us. All right, thank you for listening, and have a good night.
Thank you for listening online to the Eli Sports Network.